but I'm going to pick Learned. I think it's going to be more of a challenge, but it's going to be more interesting. Yep. Last chance gas. Sometimes failing a task can lead to more interesting results than if you had succeeded. Everything about this spectral figure seems dreamlike. The Spectre. Well, he's called the Spectre. He is a hazy silhouette who seems to be made of blue glass smoke. He wears stylish, well-cut clothes. His handsome, bearded face seems hauntingly familiar, though you've never seen him before. He breathes a sigh of relief when he sees you. We weren't sure that would work. We pooled our strength and channeled it through me to reach you, to wake you up. He glances at the other figures here and frowns unhappily. It took more out of them than we thought. The other reflections, they're more like shadows now. I gotta take a drink here. Look, I'll bet you've got a lot of questions. This whole place is basically your mind. Your body's still out there in the real world, healing from that fall. You need to get out there and finish the process. He shrugs. It shouldn't be too hard. How do you know all this? All that you're telling me? He throws up his hands in frustration. I'm just a part of you. I look at you and I know. This place was made for you, for us. And I remember pieces of knowledge that come to me when you ask your questions. But that's all. Who are you? He's already answered that, actually. He pauses and looks down at himself, considering a long time before answering. I'm you. I'm a part of your mind, a splinter. I was waiting here for you. We called you, with the memories of the others who are here. I don't know what happened next. If this place is my mind, why don't I remember any of this? Any of you? It's your mind. A construct built to, I don't know, share thoughts? Store your true self? Wait, you know how people say, in the first place? This is definitely the first place of your memory. Well, it was the first place for me, anyway. You'd probably know better, since it's yours. If you don't remember now, maybe it'll come to you later. Who are these other people? You call them reflections? That's what they are. As I said, it's your mind. You'll find reflections of people you knew. People you met in the real world, and with whom you shared some kind of psychic connection. I don't know how or why. It just happens. You said I had to finish the process. What do you mean by that? After you wake up from the dreamscape state and attune to the tides, you'll need to find something called a resonance chamber. Your body should have landed somewhere near it. Just climb inside that and everything will be fine. What's a resonance chamber? I remember pieces about it, but not the whole. It's a crystal sarcophagus. I remember it having 5 mechanical arms around it and a metal ring set in the floor. I think we were aiming for it when we fell. When you open your eyes in the real world, it should be nearby. What do you mean by attuned to the tides? Tides are like a force, like gravity or magnetism or something, except they respond to people's actions and perceptions. Your body, that is, your body in the real world, needs the tides to survive. It's not something you need to worry about. Your body will attune as it wakes up. Before I met you, it felt like something was hunting me. Do you know what it was? He closes his eyes. That's a memory I don't want to recall. Large, black, furious. It's our death. It's the sorrow. He closes his eyes. I hope it's lost interest in you. If it finds us, we're done for. So how do I get back to the real world? There's a portal down there. It'll take you back to your body. Just step through it, and the whole tides thing should take care of itself. He crosses his arms. When you wake up, find the resonance chamber and activate it. Then we can... What in the hell is that? It's the sorrow. Gods, it's the sorrow. The sorrow is anchored to those reflections. It's devouring their power. We have to get rid of them. Destroy its anchors, or else the sorrow will erase us forever. Crisis initiated. Kill the reflections anchoring the sorrow to your mind. A crisis begins when you enter into a dangerous situation. Crises are turn-based encounters where you can fight, sneak, manipulate the environment, or talk your way out of trouble. Each turn, you can take one action to attack or activate an ability. You can also make one move. That reflection near you, kill it. You'll loosen the sorrow's anchor. Okay, I guess he means that one. Right, effort. Sorrow's turn. What? It's escaping. It's going to hide inside your mind. Now run. Get to the next one. I don't want it hiding in my mind. Double move.
Go.
Is that what I'm supposed to do?
Yes.
That's my double move? Okay. So it's not hitting me. Still telling me about effort. Sorrow infection. What is it doing now? It's infecting it somehow. Fettles. Temporary conditions are status effects that can improve or reduce a character's stats. The sorrow has just placed a fettle on the remaining reflection. You can't remove this fettle, but you may find a way to overcome it. Okay, we're gonna overcome it this way. We missed. The fettle the sorrow placed on this character has boosted its armor by 10, meaning it will absorb 10 points of damage from each attack. The reflection's armor is now too high for you to overcome with your unarmed attack. Skist. The reflection's protected somehow. You need to find a way to hit it even harder. That thing's cool looking. Grab that piece of mirror glass. It might have enough residual energy to kill the reflection. This? Or that? To pick up loot, yeah.
Ready.
Shimmering glass. Deals 13 physical damage and refills all user stat pools. This is a fragment of the mirror that the Sara shattered in the calm. Oh, this is the calm? It holds a reflection of you, frozen in time and surrounded by a corona of multicolored energies. Use item. Right. First, take all. Left click on the items icon in the bar above your portrait. Is that this? Oh, there it is. So I could also, if I wanted to, I could use the Onslaught. But that only deals 5 damage. So that wouldn't even be enough. I wonder if I could use Innervate on the Reflection. That'd be pretty cool, huh? Cool. 40 XP, baby. You pried it loose. That thing is a cancer, an infection. It's unstoppable, but you stopped it. He holds his head in his hands. I can't believe it found us. In here. He looks at you, terror in his eyes. That thing, the sorrow, it's been hunting you. It's what killed you in the first place. It'll keep hunting you until you activate the resonance chamber. I didn't remember until I saw it, but that's why the chamber is so important. You have to get back and activate the chamber before it's too late. The portal to your body is that shimmering dome there. Go. Now. Yeah, I was looking at that. What if I talk to him instead? I've told you everything I know. Until you get to the resonance chamber, I'm as blind as you. He points to the rift in space leading back to the real world. Just head back through that portal, activate the chamber, and we're healed. It's as simple as that. What is the sorrow? That thing that was here, that enormous shadow, that was just the smallest piece of it. You felt it. You saw it. It's our death. I don't know anything more than that. Tell me who you are again. I'm you. A piece of you that broke off when the sorrow attacked us as you fell. Alright, I'm gone. Good luck.
Yes.
What's this? The sorrow shattered the mirror leading back to the dark fathom. Glass shards hiss when you touch them. So this is the calm. Got it.
Yes.
Yes. We go bye-bye. Sleeping. Restored. Stuff.
Where did she fall from? Her body smashed to Tulk. It's a wonder she's still breathing.
Tulk.
All I saw was the corona, not her origin point. But look, she's healing already. Spontaneous regeneration.
Yep, I'm awesome. Will you look at... Wait, I know that face. That's funny. Aligern. Aligern? Ugh, what was that? What did you do, Callistege? His tone has become accusatory, suspicious. You open your eyes. The first thing you notice is this man's kaleidoscope of tattoos writhing across his forearms. He wears a long, dark coat, belted at the waist, supplies filling the pockets. His boots are worn and stained with years of travel. You blame me? Callistege says. She emitted an internal physiological reaction in response to the fall, probably related to that fantastic healing process. Obviously, Aligern. Her voice rolls and hisses, and you have to rub your eyes to be sure that you're not seeing double. Faint echoes of her actions trail from her, each nearly mimicking her, though some act and react to stimuli that you can't perceive. Her vivid hair and outrageous clothing remain constant through these shadows. Aligern says, oh yes, it's obvious, Callistege. His voice is grim and clipped. Then he sees you looking at him. You're no ordinary mortal. We know that much. Start talking. His voice is hard and set, so we can see what he's thinking. She's the changing god. Callistege is deliberately blinding herself. But why? Now, if we react... I don't know if that happens in the game, but if we react... If we choose something that's reacting to the scanned thoughts, they're probably going to figure out we're reading their mind. Who are you? So Silver Tide raised a tiny amount. Aligern says, if you don't remember who I am, You're more self-centered than I've ever imagined. Callistege says, you know she's not the changing god, Aligern. And she thinks Aligern's being more paranoid than usual. How long must I put up with him? Aligern says, it's her face. I've never seen any other people rebuild themselves like that. Only the changing god could have healed so quickly. He sighs and rubs his face, trying to regain his composure. Maybe you could help me for a change. You know what this means to me. You're familiar with the word changing, Aligern? It implies inconstancy. Thus, the changing god may well have changed. Several versions of her shrug, and she addresses you. You'll have to forgive him. He believes you're someone he once knew, even though it's painfully obvious to anyone that you are newly born. Her most solid self curtsies while others bow or spin. I and my sisters am Callistege. This is Aligern. We are explorers, knowledge seekers. That's how we came to be in this room. If I'm not mistaken, you are what we call a cast-off. The changing god created you, body and mind. Your sire used your body for a time, then abandoned it for reasons of his own. When his mind departed for a new experience, you were born in his cast-off shell. Who is the changing god? Huh? That's something coming from you, Aligern says. Callistege gives him a sidelong glance. The changing god is your sire, dear. He discovered a path to immortality long ago, a means to transfer his self to a new body of his own creation. I don't think he knew, however, that when he abandoned one body, another mind was birthed to fill the void. Aligern says, oh, he knew all right. He eyes you up and down coldly. The only thing the changing god cares about is himself. He doesn't give a single thought for those he leaves behind. And he thinks he sees us as experiments, not humans. If you know the changing god through my body, why do you keep referring to my sire as he? Callistege says, we know your creator through legend and research. He's taken the form of men, women, visitants, and other things. His form is fluid, as his name suggests, but the stories about the changing god always refer to him. It's easier, Aligern shrugs. You are a woman. The changing god is himself. Where are we? What is this place? A sanctum of your sire's. The common belief is he has several such places throughout the Ninth World, possibly other worlds as well. We were only just able to gain entry to this one because of your grand entrance. Are there other cast-offs? Callistege says, dozens, hundreds. Who can say? Your sire has been doing this for several centuries. Aligern says, though if all of them were born the way you claim to have been, it's a wonder any of them survive. So you say I was born when the changing god left, but why am I not dead? Aligern says, I used a cipher to slow your fall further. Oh, good. That answers that, but the damage still would have killed an ordinary person. But think about it. If you're the kind of person who can make your body into anything you want, what do you do? If you've constructed bodies for centuries, you want to make each one better than the last. You want to live forever. You're not going to let your life end by accident. No, you'll make strong bodies. Fast, powerful. Maybe throw in regeneration while you're at it. Callistege says, the changing god has always been vain. He rarely stays long in a shell that doesn't suit his self-image. She looks you up and down, her smile suddenly unnerving. Perhaps the changing god fled because he didn't want to wear those scars of yours. How can you be sure this body's a cast-off? You mean aside from your miraculous reformation? Callistege says. For one thing, there's your tattoo. All cast-offs have one, though its purpose is beyond me. And then, of course, there's your delicious naivete. Aligern says she could be faking it. You don't live hundreds of years without learning to lie convincingly. Ofer, she sighs in exasperation, then says to you, what do you think? Are you a newborn child, or are you a powerful immortal whom death has robbed of his memories? Aligern crosses his arms and growls, fine. What do you think? Aligern thinks this should be interesting. You obviously knew the changing god, Aligern. What do you think? Am I him? Ooh, blue tide raised a small amount. That is just the kind of question he would ask. He scrutinizes you in a way he hadn't before. You carry yourself with the same arrogance, that glint of knowing everything about our world and the worlds before it. Your personality? That's very much the same. Aligern says, if you're not him, you're his god's damn spitting image. He spits as if to emphasize the point. You have a lot to answer from a lot of people. And he thinks, people like me. Callistege says, ask, what are you basing that conclusion on, Aligern? Your feelings? He looks away, and his composure slips a little. God, you're so rancid sometimes, Callistege. If the changing god abandoned my body, where is he now? Aligern says, if he abandoned your body, then his consciousness fled to another. He eyes you keenly. Oh, do stop. The look she gives Aligern is equally piercing, amplified by the withering glares of her sisters. If there's one thing we know about the changing god, dear, it's that he always has a contingency. This child was born here. The object of your obsession will have been reborn somewhere else. What was that blast of energy when I woke? Callistege says, as I was telling my colleague, it was obviously a physiological reaction of some kind. I've never witnessed the birth of a cast-off, but yes, it could very well have been caused by your nascent consciousness. Don't worry, I don't believe it caused any real harm. Not to me, at least. Really? Aligern says. You've been more abrasive than ever since we came in here. He shoots her a sidelong look. She just can't emphasize with other people unless she's experimenting on them. Do you know anything about the tides? I've heard that term before. A subject your sire studied in great depth. I'm afraid it isn't my field of inquiry. Are you sure that surge didn't hurt you? Aligern says, if it did, it was damaging our minds. Though how you check if it carked her, I couldn't say. Tough to find normalcy there. At least we know it didn't hurt Aligern. That skull's as thick as organic stone. These two get along so well. Okay. So I want to ask about something else. Of course, child. You must be so disoriented. Okay, so that's again. Why do you seem to hate the changing god so much? Aligern's face is calm, but his voice is bitter and tired. You should know, shouldn't you? You've ruined lives, committed crimes, and now it seems like you've forgotten the harms you engineered. You've left a trail of the dead and dying behind you. Callistege and her echo share an expression as equal parts amused and appalled. She's not the changing god, Aligern. If falling from the sky didn't kill me, is there anything that can? An excellent question, Callistege says. Having seen your regenerative abilities in action, I suspect they are primarily physical, a regrowth. If that's the case, you'd be unable to survive most varieties of psychic or molecular decomposition, disintegration, conflagration, and so forth. Degenerative diseases could pose a problem, and I know of several entities capable of psychic destruction. As she speaks, a vision flashes into your mind. It's not yours, exactly. Somehow, you know this is a memory of the changing gods. You are in a dark room, lit by a myriad of blinking lights and holograms from the many machines surrounding you. What about a body that can withstand the sorrow's attacks? Says a voice. It seems to be coming from one of the machines. No, you reply. The thing has no respect for barriers of any kind. Physical, temporal, psychic. This is the only way. With a series of gestures, you bring up an image of a crystalline pod. If the resonance chamber works, it will give us the power to stop the Sorrow's hunt once and for all. We just need the right focal point, a catalyst. The memory fades. Callistege is still talking. You realize that the device you saw in the memory is identical to the one behind you now. It looks just like the Spectre had described it, a transparent sarcophagus inside a crystalline dome, with mechanical arms arrayed around it on a metal ring. Unfortunately, the dome is shattered, the sarcophagus is cracked, and one of the arms is in pieces on the floor. Whatever its function, it clearly needs repair. Callistege is continuing, or flesh-eating viruses. One presumes disfigurement by the Iron Wind would likewise be devastating enough, too. Aligern says, I think she gets the point, Callistege. I saw a vision of myself in another time and place, just now. You didn't see it too, did you? Aligern says, I saw you stare into space while Callistege graphically described all the ways you could die, but that's about it. He snorts. I only noticed because I did the same thing. Do either of you know anything about the Sorrow? Aligern says, I've had my share of sorrows, but never the sorrow. What's that, a disease? Callistege's mouth compresses in a tight line. I know nothing about it. Wish I could hear her thoughts right now. Be right back, guys. Before I woke, I was in some kind of dreamlike labyrinth with a glowing specter. With how hard you hit the ground? I'm surprised that's all you saw, Aligern says. Do either of you know how to fix that crystal chamber there?
I'll remember that.
Huh. Aligern chuckles. Then, firm and certain, he says, Not likely. Though it might not be impossible. You need people with the appropriate knowledge. I'm sure the cult of the changing god will hold the answer. Callistege's distaste is evident in the expressions of her echoes, although the face of the one in the lead remains carefully impassive. You turn to the insane to help a newborn. Where's your judgment, Aligern? I would take her to the Order of Truth. The Order of Truth? Are you mad? They would sooner take us apart. What's the Order of Truth? Callistege says, Knowledge seekers. The learned who try to wrest secrets from the hearts of the prior worlds. They gather in the city to exchange their findings and help humanity to build a brighter future. She smiles brightly. Our friend Aligern here was once one of them. He says frauds, quacksalvers, and charlatans. They don't have all the answers, and I'd not trust them with the changing god's secrets. You're just angry that they couldn't help you with yours. Her echoes tinkle laughter. But I am being too cruel, dear Aligern. Let us take our new friend to the Order. What's the cult of the changing god? Aligern says, despite what she says, they're not insane. They're eccentrics. She laughs, but he soldiers on. They're worshippers of, well, of you or your sire, the changing god. They devote their lives to understanding your kind. Huh. I don't know where I want to go. I want to look around this room first. I have some other questions. Can I ask some more questions about this cast-off body? Certainly, dear. What do you want to know? Well, that's it. I do want to look around this room, but I don't know how to... I don't know how to exit out of this without dismissing them, and I don't want to dismiss them because I don't have to go find them somewhere. The The Order of Truth, Callistege says. She'll gladly take me. Or the Cult of the Changing God, Aligern says. The Order of Truth knows nothing about this sort of thing. I'll show you where the cult can be found. Interesting, though. We have an option to ask about this again, but not the Order of Truth. Callistege says charitably, lunatics. Aligern is in fine company with them. They find godhood in a man, obsessively follow his movements, and canonize his get. They'll love you one way or another. Okay. I really don't like Aligern as much. And, the two of them, I trust Aligern the least. So, Callistege, will you take me to the Order of Truth? Of course. Once I provide an introduction to the priest, we'll have your chamber fixed in no time. Aligern says you'll end up without your clothes and broken in a ditch while she laughs it off as a good experiment. It's probably best I come with you as well. Suspicious as always, Aligern. Child, the world is an exciting place, but it is full of dangers. Rest assured, one of us will get you safely to where you need to be. I'll be right behind you. A sunny smile crosses her faces, and she thinks, I shudder to think what Aligern might do to the child. Huh. Why do you want to go with me? What's in it for you? Callistege says, I won't deny that you're an exciting find, but it's not about that. I just want to see you safely out of the reef. And she thinks, who knows what secrets this child could help me find if I can help her live long enough. Well, she's in it for her own reasons, but at least she wants us to live. That's always a good thing. Aligern says, kid, you're not safe here. And not just because you're new. Treasure hunters trawl the reef. Scavengers who would sell you for parts if they knew where you came from, what you were. He thinks, if she's not the changing god, she needs my help. And if she is... Alright, let's go.